The distributed nature of a company is something that you have to do. So this is, from our experience, one of the things that turn your hobby into a profession you can actually make money with. It's a pretty cool thing. This is a long vision, keeps you quite motivated. But then again, everyone else has this size and goals, and of course, maybe they So feel free to work from anywhere. A colleague of mine from the US just worked out of study for MIT, just because they can. You can set up your schedule. Since you just get a task and you have to deliver it at some point, you're free to set up your work time. You can work whenever you feel you're most productive. Of course, if you are a support team, if you have a fixed schedule, differences can be a benefit but also a curse. I end up to work in such an environment, you have to be able to express yourself. So communication skills, especially in writing, English, are must, otherwise you don't get anywhere. And there's a certain amount of system information required. You are at home all by yourself. This is your laptop. There's nobody able to fix it if it's wrong. So the people that work for us, you should have a bit of a technical background. And of course, we do have an IT team. We can help desk so people can call and ask for help. But it's usually impossible to go on site and fix the problem. So people working for us usually are technically inclined to work with stuff. And then motivation already, you have to be quite motivated if you want to work from home. And in isolation as well. And since many of us have worked on other open source projects before, they already have been exposed to this kind of thing. So they are on the mailing list, they are discussing with the hackers, they know how to get it, they know how to document stuff, and things like that have been established. Requirements on your work environment. Set up office room is very helpful and handy if you can. And being able to lock the door to work away in the office is very important to be able to show that you can actually take a break. I must admit, my office is right next to our bedroom under the roof, so it's very tempting to just check in one more short time before we go to bed. As said, you have to take care of your equipment, and we have a hardware budget for everybody, so you have a certain amount of money for each year that you can spend keeping your equipment up to date, starting from laptops and screens and printers to very important things like a good office chair or table. Even for these kind of things, we have recommendations and require people to make sure that their desk and their work environment is suitable and appropriate for the not have their sitting in front of it. Very important for fast and reliable internet connections, you can't really work for us if you are online, especially since we are so dependent on instant messaging capacity. So downtime of internet connection is usually one of the notable events that everybody gets aware of. It was less of time today because the line broke down something that we usually have colleagues that then inform everybody else that you want to listen to online. And since we work on a very wide range of platforms, I myself use open source and Linux on my desktop, we have a few Windows users, we have people using FreeBSD for their development environments. All these organizations have to communicate somehow, so we are very dependent on platform neutral formats for documents and protocols that we use. And a lot of our infrastructure is based on open source and open technology because of this requirement. We also try to have fun from time to time. I've taken a few pictures from past company meetings. This year was on the top right. Here was the entire MySQL development team back at that time. The picture on the left is the staff meeting in Cancun, Mexico, that took place in 2004. As you can see, we have grown a bit by then. But this was the entire company, not only the developers. And while at Cancun, we were snorkeling, and we had lots of other activities outdoors to meet with colleagues that you usually don't have to touch with. They delivered the exhibits, so we had people get a better person. charge for them to be done through the payment process. They send an invoice to one of the closest entity of the headquarters, that depends on where it's located. And the second question was about regular employees and what kind of contract they have. Depends on the country, they usually have regular contracts that match terms interestingly, everybody in MySQL, for example, used to get 25 days of vacation in the US, which was, for Germans, it sounds very low compared to the usual 30 days that you get. For the Americans, it was just a blessing. You usually don't get that much days of vacation. So in some areas, you have to make a trade-off, but most of it has been negotiated individually. You make people that work in different countries. It's tricky. And why money all across the globe is challenging and sometimes can be expensive depending on what means of money transport you have to use. It's hard to tell on a general scale. It really depends on what country we're talking about. For Eastern countries, you try to have an agency to take care of that. Yeah.